Hello and welcome class. Today we will be starting with a new chapter, chapter 3 in mathematics, pair of linear equation in two variables. Scoring chapter if you are good in addition, subtraction and solving part, because this is all about calculation part. Now let us understand first what is the meaning of the chapter, pair of linear equation. The word pair means two equations, two pair of linear equations in two variable. Now before I explain in two variable, we have already learned in 9th standard about the one variable ax plus b form, ax plus b equal to 0. Okay, equations means equal to 0 form. Now ax plus b equal to 0, it is a linear equation in one variable. Because why I am telling it is linear, because the degree means, if the degree is 1, I can say it is linear. Example 3x plus 4 equal to 0, this is a linear equation in one variable, only one variable is there. Now pair means there are two equations. So if I'm writing 4x plus 5 equal to 0, this is a pair of linear equation in one variable. Two pairs are there, but in this chapter we'll learn about pair of linear equation in two variable. It means ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a and b both are not 0. Both cannot be 0. Okay, in this a is not 0 and a and b are real numbers, and here also a, b, c are real number. Any equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, okay, here you will have two variables, because we are learning about two variables. Pair means there will be two equations, 3x plus 4y plus 6 equal to 0 and 2x plus 6y plus 3 equal to 0. So the meaning of the chapter is pair. This is two pair. Linear means degree is 1. So see, the degree is, the highest power is 1 only. X is x power 1, y power 1, the linear equation in two variable. There are two variable, x and y. Okay, so this chapter we will be learning for solving these two equation. Okay, so pair of linear equation, two variable, we have to find x and y. We have how many methods? Let us check. We can find x and y value with the help of first is geometrically, with the help of graph. With graph we can solve and get the answer of x and y. If we want to find x and y, what is common x and y to get answer 0? If this is the two equations, what is common x and y which will satisfy the equation? So there is one, my first method is graphical method. With the help of graphical method, second is substitution method. Then we have elimination method. Then after elimination we will learn about cross multiplication method. Okay, these are the four important topics. Then subtopics are reducing method and other subtopics are there, but these are the four topics in which these two equations can be solved. If I want to get answer of x and y, what is a common x and y in these two equations to get the answer? Before we understand this, let us understand first more basics, which is about, if you know about the graphical part, if you are drawing a graph of x plus y equal to 3, the graph will come a straight line. You will get a straight line in graph because the degree is 1. If the degree is 1, you will always get a straight line in graph. And as you draw the second graph, okay, there are two equations, it means there will be two straight lines. Now two straight lines can have three possibilities. If you have two equations in graphical, there are three options. Let us check that. Now if there are two equations, a1x plus, or we can say b1y plus c equal to 0, because general form is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. If there are two equations, a1x plus b1y plus c equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c equal to, or you can c1 and here c2 equal to 0. Now if I'm talking graphically, I know this also will give me a straight line, this also will give me a straight line. There are three possibilities. One possibility is the line will never intersect. Second possibility of this, because this is also a line, this is also a line, you can either get this way, they will never intersect. Second possibility is they will intersect at exactly one point. And third possibility is that they will coincide. It means they are at same point. They are on the same. They are same as it is. Okay. So there are three possible equation possible. Okay. There are three possibility of graph. First is parallel lines. Second is intersecting lines. And third is coincident lines. So let us understand this in more proper way. Parallel lines. These are parallel lines. Parallel lines. This is intersecting lines. Intersecting lines. In this, how many solution you will get? Is there any common answer? Nothing. So there is no solution. Here, how many answer? Only one answer. Unique solution. Here it is, infinite answer. So let us see the understanding part of this. If it is a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2, if I am taking ratio of this, let me do it over here. If I am taking a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2, if the ratio is a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2, it is intersecting lines. I'll get a graph of intersecting line. Example, if the question is 3x plus 4y plus 6 equal to 0 and 2x plus 3y plus 2 equal to 0. Now this is a1, b1 and c1, and this a2, b2 and c2. If a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2, it is intersecting line. It means if I check the ratio 3 upon 2, which is not equal to 4 upon 3. This is a1, this is b1 and this is c1. This is a2, b2 and c2. Already I have talked about this. So if these two are not equal, directly I will say it is intersecting lines. They are intersecting lines, and we can say it has unique solution. It has unique solution. If you will try to draw graph of these two equations, if you draw graph of this and graph of this, you will get this answer. You will get an intersecting line. They will intersect at exactly one point. Unique means exactly one. Unique means only one answer you will get. One answer. Okay. Only one answer you will get in this. Unique solution. Okay. Similarly, if a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. If all are equal, if you are getting everything equal, you will get this line. Coincidence. One after the other. So if all are equal, we can say the example 3x plus 2y plus 4 equal to 0. And second is 6x plus 4y plus 8 equal to 0. If the equation is in this form, let us check. If you divide 3 upon 2, 2 upon 4 and 4 upon 8. If you observe, all are coming 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2. It means a1 upon a2, b1 upon b2 and c1 upon c2. All are equal. All are 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2. If all are equal, then they are. It is coincident. Coincident lines. And here, infinitely many solution. Infinitely many solutions are there. Okay. Because here I am getting so many answer. Every point answer is same. Here I am getting only one solution. Unique solution. Here, infinitely many solution. Now the last part is parallel line. The first formula is of this intersecting lines. Okay. Intersecting lines is also known as. Okay, intersecting lines. The second one was coincident line. Second is coincident line. The last one is parallel lines. Now, parallel lines means parallel lines formula will be a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 not equal to c1 upon c2. Let us see the example. It is, let's say 3x plus 4y plus 6 is equal to 0 and here 6x plus 8y plus 3 equal to 0. Now if I divide 3 upon 6 is equal to 4 upon 8 is equal to 6 upon 3, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2 and here 2 upon 1. So if you observe, 1 upon first 2 are equal and last one is not equal. 1 upon 2 equal to 1 upon 2 which is not equal to 2 upon 1. So it is a1 upon a2, b1 upon b2 not equal to c1 upon c2. This is known as parallel line. This way the graph will come. If you try to draw this graph, both will never intersect. Therefore, it has no solution. No answers you will get. No intersection means no solution. No solution also known as inconsistent. If you are not getting any answer, it means it is inconsistent answer, inconsistent. And intersecting is known as consistent. Coincident also known as consistent. If you are getting any answer, it means consistent. Intersecting also I am getting one answer. One answer. You are getting one answer intersecting. So it means consistent. Again you are getting infinite answer. It is consistent. We are getting no answer. So inconsistent. So just drawing at the part, it is a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2. a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 equal to c1 upon c2. And the last one, a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 not equal to c1 upon c2. There are three type of equations. The first one is intersecting or unique solution. This is all are equal, so coincident, okay, coincident, infinite solution. And the last one is parallel lines have no solution. This is consistent. Everything is given in your textbook, but still for reference I'm just showing you. In just do a recap. In this is consistent, this is consistent. No answer means inconsistent. Okay, and if you want to see the diagram, this will be like intersecting. It will intersect. They will coincide one after the other, and this is parallel. So I've just drawn a rough diagram of all. This is what the introduction part. Now we have understood the equation, pair of linear equation, two variable can have three possibilities. It can intersect, or it can coincide, or it can be parallel. Now we will be talking about almost all the topics about intersecting only, because I want one solution. These two topics graphically you have to understand and check. Now methods are there, which is 3x plus 4y plus 6 equal to 0, 8x plus 6y plus 4 equal to 0. Now for the exercise it is given, just to check by seeing these two equations, just you have to find which type of equation it is. Is it intersecting, is it parallel, or it is coincident? Can you easily check? Your answer is 3 upon 8 is equal to 4 upon 6 is equal to 6 upon 4. Let us check what you are getting. 2 2s are 2 3s are 2 3s are 2 2s are. I am getting what? 3 upon 8, this is 2 upon 3, and this is 3 upon 2. First two are not equal. So directly you can say first two are not equal. Directly you can say which answer it is. This intersecting answer. The answer is, this is intersecting lines. Okay. So in the first exercise only they have asked about which type of equation it is. So easily you can do the first exercise. And they have also asked about consistent. Which equation is consistent? If you solve the question, is this consistent? Yes, because it is intersecting line, so it is consistent also. Okay, so the first exercise introduction part, only this much is there. You have to just simply read the question. With the help of the introduction topic, easily you will be able to solve the first exercise. Okay, so I believe this was easy to do it. Thank you.